on to our report section tonight. 2017-18 strategic plan update from Jim Ginnerman.
Awesome. Thank you so much for having me here tonight. I do want to share with you that I'm standing here, but it's really, I'm representing the work on behalf of all my team members that are here around the room, but also within the buildings. Prior to me coming on board, the district strategic plan was in place and strategic goals were set and action steps were in place. It's been my job to really help facilitate the action steps as we work throughout the year. So tonight, what I'll be doing is giving a brief update. Some of the goals are measured on our state assessments or some accountability, like the state accountability report card, that we don't have those results just yet. And so some of this will be to be determined once we have that information. So in the area of learning, in our red bucket, so to speak, this goal, we're not able to say whether we've met it or not just yet. We will be able to say that in fall when we have the accountability report card. We have been monitoring our student performance for all students in the area of math and the English language arts, and so we continue to do that throughout the school year. I can share with the board as a reminder, and some of you are new, so you may not have remembered this from last year, but in the area of the ELA gap on the district report card, last year our score was 17.1 out of 25, and our goal is to get to 18 out of 25. And then in the area of math, our goal, our performance in 16-17 was 18.25. And so our goal is written actually with some lagging data. So at the time we were writing the goal wanted to move from 15.7 out of 25 to 16.2. So based on the 16-17 data, we've already surpassed that goal. What I'll do now is just touch upon some of the action steps that are highlights of the work that we've been doing in the area of student learning. So one of the pieces is integrating the STAR assessment into our system, and that's really been K-12. We've done a lot of professional development, and so it hasn't been just a one time, here you go, here's the assessment. We've really been working with the teachers to really understand the information and then communicate that with families. So you'll see on the action steps that is an area that is green. One other action step that is green in the area of student learning is being able to understand what specific standards in ELA that our students need more support with. And so we did that just recently at a leadership team meeting where we looked at the student data, and Doug Martin was able to talk about what standards in ELA would help us to focus on moving our students forward. So we've been able to complete that as well. Another piece in the area of learning is really creating and articulating the curriculum cycles with not only the curriculum instruction team, the teaching and learning, as well as the whole leadership team. So having a plan for when we're going to review what subject areas, and then that will allow us to also budget for that and plan for professional development in the future. So we had a bucket for culture and climate engagement, and this was one of the lighter yellow-orange colors. And so this is an area that we really put on. The goal was around having a survey and increasing the results. Earlier this in winter, I provided an update that we're looking for a survey tool as well as a data solution. And so meanwhile, throughout this year, building principals were able to deploy the surveys that they were using, but you'll see later on in effective and efficient that we're on track to have those surveys for next year. I wanted to highlight some of the pieces in the area of safe and orderly. And some of the things that you'll see is some of the safety walks have been completed and conversations with Dave and building principals around those components. And always just really trying to fine tune what are next steps to ensure safety for all. On here, we have also the youth risk survey that was deployed. You'll see that that's yellow. And so I know Sharon has some of the results already, and so she just needs a little bit more time to work through some of those pieces. In the area of effective and efficient, the blue area, we had some goals around the facilities as well as the data piece. And so you're familiar with the work that's been done with the facility committee, and so you'll see that noted here as green, just to update you on the progress with that. And then also in the area of identifying an improvement system to support assessment and accessibility to data and results, we've done that. And so what we've been able to do is take our needs for surveys and then also our needs to organize our student information. And we've been able to identify a specific company that Laura had already shared some information with all the school board members. And so having one company to support us with that will be great for next year. So overall, this is just a highlight of report of just some of the action steps and where we're at. Some of the specific goals, we will be able to come around in October when the data is released.
Great. Any questions?
This goes back to the parents that we heard speak last week and currently. There's a lot of reference to the STAR data in May, a final analysis of spring STAR data. I'm concerned about how we're utilizing that data within this district. We've gone from an NWEA test to a Galileo test replacement, and now we're using a very different test, the STAR, and I'm not sure that we're applying appropriately to place kids at their ability levels. The board needs to understand how we're utilizing this data and the ramifications it's having on our students if it prevents them from being in a rigorous middle school or high school program. So I just would ask that we look at the STAR data as soon as possible to make sure that we're not limiting our kids.
And we did have a leadership team looking, and some of the pieces we looked at was like that standard information of what is the area that we can just review our curriculum for, you know, improvements. So as we look at the STAR information, it really is a progress monitor to support us in knowing if we're on track to meet the bigger goal.
I think I can say from a parent perspective, when you're looking at standards camp and you see kids that are performing at a pretty high level and they don't demonstrate growth, but the lower half does demonstrate growth, I would say that we're not closing the gaps in a way that the community probably would expect, which means our advanced learners need to continue to advance and demonstrate that on the STAR assessment, and these need to come up. So it's kind of this not bringing the top down, but bringing the bottom up and continuing that growth at the top level.
Mm-hmm. So where does the evaluation of the assessments fit into the strategic plan?
Well, evaluating what assessments we are currently doing?
More evaluating the criteria for student placement in the different classes.
That piece was not a part of the strategic plan for the 17-18 school year. It would be really more of a department piece that has been worked on through the policies.
What about the work that needs to be done with pathways in the next less than 12 months, really?
So
where would that fit in?
This report is for this just recent school year, so 17-18. So what I wanted to do was report on any student data that we have, but also the action steps. Our next discussion item is next year's strategic plan or district improvement plan. Thank you.
Any more questions? All right, let's move on to the next one.